past 20 years, there's always been a certain amount of family homelessness, and it's ebbed and flowed over the years. It is definitely on the upswing, and we've now got about well over 2,000 families, about 2,500 families living in some form of shelter, as you mentioned, many of them in motel rooms.
And for viewers who are not experiencing this directly, this might be a little surprising, because when we do see homeless people, they're usually individual adults, not moms and kids.
Waiting on the world to change. It's hard to beat the system when we're standing at a distance. So we keep waiting on the world to change. Now if we had the power to bring our neighbors home from war, they would have never missed a Christmas. No more ribbons on their door. And when you trust your television, what you get is what you got.
Well, it's such a critical time in the child's development. At no time in our lives, at any point in our life, are our brains developing at the rate they are when we're very young. At least it's supposed to be developing at a fast rate. But children experiencing homelessness are extremely traumatized. And that trauma literally has an impact on brain development. And so even if it's just for a relatively short period of time, if without without good intervention, the impact can be lifelong. And
it's okay.
all crashing and stars are falling all for us. Days grow longer and nights grow shorter. I can show you I'll be the one. I will never let you fall. I'll stand up with you forever.